Dear students, I am Sanjus Hazriya, assistant professor of English at Government College Ratangar. Today I am going to explain Matthew Arnold's poem Sohrab and Rustam's Lines from 865 to 892. As I have explained lines from 838 to 864 in my previous video. This poem is included in BA per second year by Maharaja Ganga Singh University Bikaner. And the first slide is, and night came down over the solemn west, and the two gazing hosts and that sole pair, and darkened all, and a cold fog with night crept from the oxus. Soon a hum arose as of a great assembly loosed, and fires began to twinkle through the fog. For now both armies moved to camp and took their meal. The Persians took it on the open sands southward, the Tartars by the river march, and Rustam and his son were left alone. So it is very pathetic scene. Sohrab has died, and what is the scene after his death? And night came down. Came down means descended. So night descended over the solemn waste. Solemn means desolate, lonely. West means desert. So finally the night threw its cloak of darkness all over the desolate and dreadful desert. Okay, so night descended over the desolate desert, and two armies. So the two armies that witnessed the father's grief. So, and the two gazing hosts, the two horror-struck armies, and that's all pair, and the only one pair, father and son pair, and the single pair of Sohrab and Rustam, and darkened all. And in this manner, night darkened everything, and with the nightfall, a cold mist. Cold fog means cold mist, and with the nightfall a cold mist with night crept from the oxus, and with the nightfall a cold mist slowly rose from the surface of the river Oxus. Soon a hum arose, soon a murmuring sound, humming sound means murmuring noise. So very soon there was heard a universal buzz as of great assembly loosed. As a great assembly loosed means a great crowd dispersed. So there was the humming sound. Very soon there was heard a universal buzz of low talk, as we hear when a huge assembly ends and people leave the place in small groups talking in low voices. And fires began to twinkle through the fog, and now fire began to twinkle. So now small fires began to shine dimly through the mist, through the fog. Fog means mist in front of east tent. For now both armies moved to camp, because both armies have gone into their camps. So because now both armies moved back to their camps and took their meal. And they started taking their evening meal. So there was fire before their camps. The Persians took it on the open sands. And now the Persians took their meal on the desert in the open air southward, towards the south. They were sitting towards the south. The Tartars by the river marge. While the Tartars took their meal by the side of the river bank. River marge means river bank. And Rustam and his son were left alone. For the time being. So this is very pathetic scene. This is very tragic scene, in which Rustam is sitting beside his son Sohrab, and Sohrab is dead now. So I think you understood. And now we are heading towards next slide. But the majestic river floated on out of the mist and hum of that low land, into the frosty starlight and there moved, rejoicing through the hushed Coruscant west under the solitary moon. He flowed right for the polar star, past Orgunge, brimming and bright and large. Then saints began to hem his watery march and dam his streams and split his currents that for many a league. Now, what is the natural scenery, natural scene of that area? But the majestic river floated. What is the majestic river? Here, river is Oxus. So the majestic river, the Oxus river. So the, but the royal river Oxus floated on, kept flowing. But the royal river Oxus kept flowing on out of the mist, onwards out of the fog and hum of that lowland, and the buzzing sound and the humming sound and the budging whispers of that low-lying terrain into the frosty starlight, into the frosty light of the stars. And there moved, and there moved rejoicing. Rejoicing means the river had now a brisk movement, hence rejoicing, happy movement. So their mood, there was moving, their mood happily. Rejoicing means happily. Through the hushed Coruscant west, through the silent. Hushed means silent. So, and their mood happily through the silent wasteland of Coruscant, a region of Turkestan. Under the solitary moon, under the lonely moon. So Oxus river was flowing under the solitary moon, under the lonely moon. The Oxus flowed on. He flowed right for the polar star. So Oxus river was flowing due north in the direction of the polar star. Past Orgunge, and going past Orgunge. Orgunge is a village on the Oxus, some 70 miles below Khiva and near the head of its delta. Brimming. Brimming, full of water, brimming. So, brim full of water and bright and shining brightly and large and growing larger. So, river Oxus is brimming with water, its surface is bright and it is becoming large, growing very large. Then sands begin to hem his watery march, and then sands begins. From that point outwards, the sands of the desert start pulling obstacles in the way of its forward flow, to hem, to create disturbance, to create obstacles in his watery march, in the Oxus watery march. So the obstacles were created by the desert, and dam his streams and split his currents and stop its currents and break them into divided streams. So the desert has divided into its currents and streams into small streams that for many a league. So that for miles together. So for miles together. So this desert is creating problems in the march and the movement of the Oxus river. I think you understood it. And now we are heading towards the next slide. The sown and parceled Oxus strains along through beds of sand and matted rushy isles, Oxus, forgetting the bright speed he had in his high mountain cradle in Pemere, a foiled, circuitous wanderer, till at last the longed for days of waves is heard, and wide his luminous home waters opens, bright and tranquil, from whose floor the new path the stars emerge and shine upon the Aral Sea. This is the last slide of this poem. And now the sown and parceled, the sown and parceled, So, it is through beds of sands and islands surrounded by intertwined sweeps of rushes. Here Oxus, so the Sorn and Parcelled Oxus, the Oxus River through beds of sands, it is flowing through beds of sands and islands surrounded by intertwined sweeps of rushes. Along through beds of sand and matted rushy isles. So it is moving through. So Oxus is laboring along with difficulty, divided into small parts and deprived of its old speed glory. Through beds of sands and islands surrounded by intertwined sweeps of rushes. Forgetting the bright speed of he had, and Oxus has forgotten its bright speed in the past. Here Oxus forgets its bright earlier speed that it had in his high mountains, that it had on his high mountains, on its high mountains. So the sown and parcelled. So the Oxus labors along with difficulty, divided into small parts and deprived of its old speed. And it is rushing through isles and beds of sands. Forgetting the bright speed he had, and it has forgotten the bright speed he had earlier in his high mountains, means on high mountains. Cradle in Pemere, and cradle on the plateau of Pemere, a foiled Cricetus wanderer. Cricetus means flowing in a zigzag course. Wanderer means struggler. So, cradle on the plateau of Pemere, where it was born as a small spring, turning into a tired traveler. And now it has turned into a tired traveler who has wandered far out of his way and is moving through a puzzling maze or labyrinth. Till at last, the longed for days of waves is heard. And till at last, the dashing sound of much desired union of its waves with the sea is heard. His luminous home of waters opens. What is the luminous home of waters? Means the sea. So the sea is heard, and the brightly shining and wide home of waters of different rivers. Thus Aral Sea opens up before the Oxus, bright and tranquil. And its bright and calm shape, from whose floor the new bath stars, and the Aral Sea, from whose bottom rise the newly bath stars, emerge, means came out and shine upon the Aral Sea. And these stars are shining upon the Aral Sea. So as the stars appear on the horizon, they seem to have come up out of the sea, and then they shine upon it. So I think you understood it, and now today the poem is completed. I think you understood it, and thanks for watching this video.